who inspired me a lot was Eddie Van Halen. You know, not as just a guitar player, just as a human being, as just the way he was to other people.
We grew up in Pasadena. That's the shadow of Van Halen. And actually, I think Chris lent Eddie some of his cabinets and stuff for some of the earlier shows they did at the Pasadena Civic.
Chris and Eddie were like this in the early days. I can remember numerous times going to the Pasadena Civic, and this is just before the Van Halens got their record contract. And you'd see the stage set up. Half the equipment that Eddie was using was Chris's.
There's a club called the Starwood, and it was big in the late 70s. It lasted until about 78 or 9. I played there a few times. Van Halen played there all the time. And Ed would borrow some of my equipment to play. And I didn't the guy that tuned his guitar, so I just go help move equipment. You know, I was a roadie.
They used to, you know, trade gear back and forth for the bigger shows because they didn't have the money to own all their own gear.
I grew up in Pasadena. He grew up in Burbank. It's really close to each other. And there was always a rival between Van Halen and Quiet Riot. And if you're a Van Halen fan, you don't go to Quiet Riot gigs. You know, they've all played backyard parties. And if I was caught going to a Quiet Riot gig, I'd have kicked my ass next time they saw me at a Van Halen gig. It's just, there's a big rival between them, you know.
Chris had this the right guitar that just had just the right sound that Eddie needed.
I had crashed a motorcycle, ended up in the hospital. And I was laid up in the hospital. He came in and asked if he could borrow my guitar for on his album. I said, yeah, just go by and tell my mom. I said, you can borrow it. He went over and picked it up.
This is Chris Holmes' original 1975, late 75 Ibanez Destroyer, one of the first ones off the boat from Japan.
These both came from the same store, the sound chamber, and he ended up cutting it up and ruining the sound.
He had cut a big chunk out of his, made a star out of it, and it changed the sound, and he just wanted to borrow my guitar. So I had his guitar, the one that was on the album cover.
I think they tried a couple of different guitars on that thing, but I don't think he was able to achieve the sound that he wanted through the mix.
He called Chris and he said, hey, can I borrow that Ibanez Destroyer? Because it's really a good sounding guitar, and it still is, as beat up as it is. And Chris said, okay, but you got to give me a guitar to replace it. So Chris got to take a loan of that guitar. So Edward used this guitar on Women and Children First.
They had just that right raunch to get it. Just that right raunchy crunch, and there it is. We all hear it. It's on the album. We know it.